now everything seems to be calm, partly because of our vantage point. So if you can see the green lights right there, the sign right above that says commercial main, and that's the street, that's where everything's concentrated. But I'm pretty sure if we go south on the area, we take the flat side of the car, we're just in that office, get a closer look once we get No, that's an excellent point, because in these cases, you do have people who might have seen a shooter or shooters, and it's so important to alert police so they can make an arrest. And as you noted as well when you were talking, that type of information didn't come before the shooting. And
right.
I mean, I'm making an observation here, but he definitely seemed like the biggest.
Yes, yes. And he said RPD arrived with sort of over 100 people. He's saying there must be tips out there with that many people. And like Adam said, there were no calls before the shots about any noise complaints or anything like that. So.
Yeah. All right, so here we are. And did they say, Erica, I've been saying 12:30. Is that what you heard as well?
Sometime between midnight and 12:30. I can't remember the exact time.
Yeah, and two people, and the two who were killed, they were found dead at the scene. Did you hear that?
I did not catch that. Yeah. Now, our photographer's not a guess.
Yeah, yeah, two dead. Obviously, a lot of people starting to filter in as word gets out here. Many of you might be following this, wondering if your loved one was part of this. In the chaos, it's impossible to tell. Police don't even know. But I can start to see a little bit more traffic here on the north side of the crime scene, which often happens as people try to figure out where their loved one is, what hospital, or whether they were able to run away. Families on the street corner, things like that. So, at this point, it does seem rather quiet. You have detectives coming in. If you can see, let me see if I can zoom in for you here. Sorry, my hands are getting a little cold. So right there, I mean, it's not just squad cars, but you have some bigger units here that responded. Oh, taking off right now. So that's a police vehicle. I'm not sure exactly which one, but it's on the move right now. My guess is that they are moving into the more nuanced portion of the investigation. Initially, they had to respond to the mass trauma of this shooting and help first responders, the paramedics, fire department, handle all of the victims in the case. But now they're moving into forensics. One can only imagine the number of casings on the ground right now that they're trying to analyze, see if there are multiple guns. Interviewing witnesses, unclear where that's happening. I know that in the past they sometimes have to bring in buses, especially on chilly evenings like this. I don't see that here, whether there's any RTS buses where they can turn up the heat, but that particular vehicle is heading south on North Goodman right now. You have to imagine they're going to keep this scene pretty locked up and secure throughout the morning here on Saturday. And
hey, Steve.
All right. So the staging area appears to have loosened up a little bit. I don't know maybe the other outlets. So we are on the north side of the
team. Okay, I'll talk to Ella because I caught the last 5 minutes of the conference. So I'll have him feed what he's got. Sounds good. Yep. They want us to, in a few minutes here, they're going to have us feed everything we have to News Nation. I told them, you know, I've got the last 4 minutes of the presser on my mic somewhere in the way, so I can just pass out the TV. Because I also imagine
here. Why aren't we heading back to the station? We're not going to get any updates. We've got a video. What are they expecting?